Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another edition of Oofta Premium. I'm your host, Darren Walters, and it's great to have you here. In this week's edition, we are going to discuss, really briefly, an in-game scenario that came up with my father. It was really fascinating, and it brought up some interesting points, some interesting questions that you might have at the end of the game. So we're going to go ahead and recreate that here. Just so you know. And let me go ahead and get that board set up. Alright, so here's the setup here. We've got adversity cards, two adversity cards to one. We've got cedar cultivator and crop insurance purchased by Dad. Discard this for crop insurance purchased by me. And we've only got one crop left in the bag. And so I want to make sure that it's clear. Everybody knows that you can feel your way into the bag and roughly guess how many crops are there. Or you can request to know, you know, if there's one crop left. I guess I don't have a strong and hard fast rule for that yet. Maybe somebody out there can help me work that out. But in the meantime, I think we're just going to say, upon request, you can figure out how many crops are left in the bag, because that might figure heavily into your in-game strategies. So, bearing that in mind, we're going to go ahead and get started on this. Okay, so here's the scenario that I set up with my father. And what we had was, he owned the cedar, the cultivator, the crop insurance, and adversity card, about 35 tokens. I own two adversity cards, harvester disc, and crop insurance. But what it really came down to was we had a very even score, and we had even amounts of debt. And so what turned out to be the game winner was how things played out in Final Harvest. And so if we take a look at the scenario we got here, you should bear in mind that growers can request to know how many crops are from the bag, how many are roughly left in the bag. So that can be upon request at any time in the game. I feel it's kind of crucial to know this. It obviously doesn't have to be a high amount. You have to wait until the crops are at least depleted down to, let's say, 5 or 6. But any amount under 5 or 6, you can know with precision for sure. And so, bearing that in mind, I knew that there were 4 crops left in the bag, okay? And so it was my turn. My fields were disced up, okay? So it was only gonna take 2 actions to make something happen. Well, what I did instead was I planted, knowing that I had to replace whatever I planted. I planted carrots, beans, and spinach. And I only planted 3. I didn't plant all 4. Because I knew what happens is, if you take a look at the example here, I've got 3 crops down. If I go ahead and plant the 4th one, that would instantly initiate drawing from the bag and drawing the 4 crops out. And lo and behold, if I did that, that instantly kicks off Final Harvest because we've depleted the bag. Final Harvest is sudden death. It means as soon as you run out of crops in the bag, no matter what's happening in the game, you freeze and you go into Final Harvest. Okay. Oh, but you know what? I guess I got that wrong. See, I could have done what I was going to do anyway, but let me explain what happened. So I instead of drawing all 4 crops out, so what I did was I deliberately left 1 back. I left one back because I only planted three crops. And by planting three crops, that prolongs the gain. And there are some instances in some cases where you might want to do that. Prolonging the game, and so that instead of depleting the crops and immediately ending the game, what happens instead is I got a chance to harvest, to cultivate. And the reason, of course, I want to cultivate is because I have an opportunity to do this at the end of the game. I can collect my final score, right? And so that's a big deal, because if you go into final harvest and your crops aren't ready, they haven't been cultivated, then that means, of course, you're only going to get half value. It makes a huge difference at game's end, right? So anyway, I just wanted to bring that up, and the mistake that I made was I forgot that even when you do a final harvest, the last grower is able to complete their two actions allotted to them on a regular turn before the final harvest kicks in. So all of this turned out to be a moot point because, in fact, I could deplete the bag. Even if I depleted the bag, I still would have been able to finish my turn. And so that's why that rule exists. That rule exists so we don't have scenarios where somebody is seemingly cheated out of being able to finish their play, finish up what they were doing. Now, of course, the other growers, it happened to not be on their turn. And so, in a sense, they do kind of get, I don't know the word to use, but they just don't get the opportunity to place crops out and plant. So that's just luck of the draw. That's just the chance and the luck in the game rearing its head, and something you just have to deal with. Okay. So yeah, once again, let's just iterate to make it clear. The final harvest allows you to finish your two actions on your regular turn before that sudden death scenario kicks in, and you have to harvest immediately. Okay, so we just want to emphasize that point here. All right, that's going to do it for us. Until next time, keep on playing Hope to everybody, and I'll see you later. Don't forget to check out the campaign on Indiegogo. That's $60 per game. You can make more than one contribution there if you wish. Yeah, OOF is my legacy project. It's the thing. I hope the younger generations become aware of it, because it does matter. The only way this all works is if I can get the attention of younger generations to see the value that OOF has for everyone. So, anyway, it's just something fun to do with your friends and family, and that's my goal and motivation in life. All right, we're going to leave it at that. I'll see you next time.